It has been almost 3 weeks, can you believe it, since the midterm election. And back with us tonight are Roger Putnam and Tim Robey of Putnam Robey Williamson Communications. I'm thankful to have you guys this Thanksgiving week.
Yes,
glad
and
to be here.
And you know, it had us thinking what we're all thankful for, and you're both thankful on the political scene, really.
Lots to be thankful for, yeah.
Let's start with that. Let's be positive.
All right, well, I'll start then. I'm thankful for Republican majorities.
Oh,
because
yeah.
It's what Democrats will view as opportunity. You know, the next 2 years will be like a TSA reach around. Tim, it's going to be exhilarating at first, but when it's all said and done, 2 years from now, you'll feel cheap, hollow, and maybe a little bit dirty, and nothing's been done to increase security for Americans.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, Roger, that you've actually saw the light, because I'll tell you what, we have learned our lesson, and you are going to be in the wilderness for a long time. Now, let me tell you what I am thankful for, a Scott Walker who will bring fiscal sanity back to Madison, beginning with not the rail, but the budget. And everything's on the table, and we're going to have an interesting time, but people are ready to just kind of stop the madness.
Now, let's be honest, though. Can Walker not raise property taxes and make those cuts? We're looking at what? At least $2.2
billion. Yeah, at least three.
Well, 2.3,
yeah.
Possibly.
We know Scott Walker different ways, but I'm pretty sure that there's no way on this earth that Scott Walker's going to increase the property tax.
Well, he's not going to increase taxes. But
right.
I think everything's on the table, Lee, including education.
But you'll be surprised by what he'll cut.
Yes, I think he's going to cut everything, to be perfectly honest, with the exception of maybe transportation. Well, he's not going to raid that fund like Jim Doyle did. And so it's going to be an interesting time. It's going to be very difficult. But he said, I'm going to stop the rail. And he stopped that rail. That baby's dead, by the way. Everybody in Madison, stop that craziness.
I love that you're just happiness. It's just the holidays, isn't it? You have something else you're thankful for.
Well, I'm thankful that I am going to cast a vote from Verona for the next county executive, John Holcomer, who is going to bring common sense to Dane County.
Wow. Well, I'm happy and thankful for Tammy Baldwin, because there is no Democrat in the U.S. of A. who got more votes in her district than Tammy Baldwin. That's the type of leadership and future that we're looking for.
Well, I like Tammy, too, but I like John a lot better.
Ooh, so that'll be very interesting. So any last thing you're thankful for as we wrap it up? We've got very little time.
I'm thankful for the opportunity to be able to do this show and be able to have this type of dialogue, even with somebody who I don't care for.
And I'm thankful that the voters actually rejected Obama Pelosi. Thank you very much, Roger.
Oh, my God.
Roger, I appreciate the fact that you mentioned me.
Yes.
Thank
yes.
you.
Sorry.
Not that I pick sides. Thank you guys so much. We appreciate a happy Thanksgiving to both of you. Glad that you're